Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to the class. We are discussing about photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect. Can anybody say the formula? Mathematical form of photoelectric effect. What is the mathematical form of photoelectric effect? The mathematical form of photoelectric effect is E is equal to E naught plus K. The mathematical form of photoelectric effect is capital E is equal to E naught plus K E. Instead of capital E, we can write H nu. Instead of E naught, we can write H nu naught plus K E. Here nu stands for the frequency of radiation. The nu stands for the frequency of radiation striking on the surface of the metal. Whereas nu naught stands for threshold frequency. Already I explained in the previous classes. Once again I am recalling. Nu naught stands for threshold frequency. Threshold frequency means the minimum frequency of radiation required to eject electron from the surface of the metal. Once again. The minimum frequency of radiation required to eject the electrons from the surface of the metal, that is called as nu naught. So by using this formula, today we are going to solve a problem. First of all, I'm going to share the screen. Yes, on the screen you can see a problem. Just a minute. Yes. Problem number 2.9. My dear students, on the screen you are seeing problem number 2.9. Please note down the problem. Problem number 2.9. Yes, in the problem number 2.9, what is given? What is asked? Yes, what is asked in the problem? The threshold frequency nu naught for a metal is 7.0 into 10 to the power of 14 second inverse. S inverse means second inverse. Calculate the kinetic energy of an electron emitted when radiation of frequency nu is equal to 1.0 into 10 to the power of 15 second inverse hits the metal. Here what we have to calculate? Kinetic energy of the electron emitted. Kinetic energy of the electron emitted we have to calculate. Yes, to calculate the kinetic energy of the electron emitted, kinetic energy formula Ke is equal to, the kinetic energy formula Ke is equal to, what we can write Ke? We can write the Ke as kinetic energy of the electron emitted is equal to H nu minus H nu naught. So by using this formula and by substituting the given values, we can calculate the kinetic energy of the emitted electron. And you know that H value means Planck's constant. Planck's constant. Nu means frequency of metal striking on the surface of the metal. And nu naught is the threshold frequency of a metal that is striking on the surface of the metal. Yes, we are going to substitute the values. So this is the problem based on photoelectric effect. And we are going to calculate the kinetic energy of the emitted electron. Formula H nu minus H nu naught, that is equal to H of nu minus nu naught. H value is the Planck's constant value, 6.6256. Into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. H is the Planck's constant value, 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. And a nu value, how much nu value is given? What is the nu value given? In the problem, what is the nu value given? Yes, if you are having the textbook, you can read the question very easily. Nu value given as See this one. Frequency nu is equal to 10 to the power of 15 is given. Frequency nu is given as 1.0 into 10 to the power of 15 second inverse minus nu naught. Nu naught means threshold frequency. Threshold frequency is given as 7.0 into 10 to the power of 14. So these are the values given in the problem. Yes, coming to the board. H value, Planck's constant value is 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second. New value, frequency of metal 1.0 into 10 to the power of 15 is given. Nu naught is given as 7.0 into 10 to the power of 14. All of you know how to do this problem, how to do the simplification. Here 10 to the power of 15 is there. Here 10 to the power of 14 is there. I am converting this term into 10 to the power of 14. Ten to the power of 15 is equal to 10 into 10 to the power of 14. Once again, 10 to the power of 15 is equal to 10 into 10 to the power of 14. 10 into 1.0, that is 10. Once again, 10 into 1.0 is 10. So I can write it as 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into this 1.0 is written as 10 into 10 to the power of 14 minus 7.0 into 10 to the power of 14. Yes, this term is having 10 to the power of 14. This term is having 10 to the power of 14. We can take the 10 to the power of 14 as common. Then we can write it as 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34. Now, by taking the 10 to the power of minus 14 as common, now here the term is 10. Here the term is 7. 10 minus 7. 10 minus 7, that is 3. 3 into 10 to the power of 14. So this is the simplification. And you can calculate. You will get the answer. Can you calculate? Can you calculate itself? Yourself? Yes, 6.6256. 6.6256. Wait a minute. 6.6256 into 3. So the value is 19.8768 into 10 to the power of value, 10 to the power of 14. Yes, what is calculated here? KE, that is kinetic energy, is calculated. Energy units. What are the units of energy? The units of energy is joules. Why we are taking joules means, because here Planck's constant value is taken in the joules second. Once again, the Planck's constant value is taken in the joules second. Hence, the calculated kinetic energy units are going to be the joules. So this is the value. Yes, once we will check the answer in the textbook. No need to write down because I sent the PDF. Already I sent the PDF. You can see the PDF and you can verify. Yes, on the screen you are seeing the answer. 1.988. This is your answer on the screen. 1.988 into 10 to the power of minus 19. My dear students, yes, just a minute, sorry. Yes, we have to consider the 10 to the power of values. Sorry, my dear students. Here, 10 to the power of minus 34 is there. Here, 10 to the power of 14 is there. So we have to do this calculation also. 10 to the power of minus 34 plus 10 to the power of 14. Yes, what is the 10 to the power of value here? Can anybody say what is the 10 to the power of value? Yes, correct. 10 to the power of 20. So sorry, my dear students. So this is the value 1.98768 into 10 to the power of 20. R that is written as yes, on the screen you can see 1.988 into See this one. Here minus 34 is there. Minus 34 is there. So during the calculation, you have to be very careful. 10 to the power of value is given as minus 34 here. Here 14 is there. So minus 34 plus 14. That is minus 20. It is not 20, minus 20. So the final answer is 19.8768 into 10 to the power of minus 20 joules. Yes, it should be written as 1.98768 into, when the decimal is moved to left side, 19.8 is written as 1.98 into 10. Once again, 19.8 is written as 1.98 into 10. Into 10, 10 means 10 power 1. 10 power 1 minus 10 power minus 20, that is equal to 10 power minus 19 joules. So this is our final answer. So finally, we can write here, what is the kinetic energy? The kinetic energy of the ejected electron, or emitted electron is equal to 1.98768. Actually, no need to write all the numbers because you know the significant figures. So according to significant figures, we can take only 4 decimal values. So I'm going to neglect this one. So because more than 5 is there, so the before value 1 is added. Now I can take the value as 1.9875 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. So this is our final answer. So during the calculation, you have to be very careful. Here, minus 34 is given in the 10 power. Here, 14 is there. That means minus 34 plus 14 means minus 20. And we get the value as 19.8. That 19.8 is taken as 1.98. Then 10 power minus 20 becomes as 10 power minus 19. So this is a problem based on photoelectric effect. To calculate the kinetic energy, what is the formula? H nu minus H nu naught. Here nu naught stands for threshold frequency. Yes, already this was given in the notebook as in the form of PDF. Just listen to the online class. No need to write during the online class. In my class, there is no need to write because already I'm sending the PDFs. Simply by seeing the PDFs, you can write after completion of the class. Yes, coming to the next topic. This is all about photoelectric effects. So our next topic is, on the screen, you are going to see the next topic. Yes, our next topic is, this is the next topic. Evidence for quantized electronic energy levels. Actually, we are studying about the structure of atom. First model is Thomson's model, of atom. It is having some drawbacks. That's why the next atomic model proposed is Rutherford's model of atom. Of course, Rutherford's model of atom is also having some defects, that is drawbacks. That's why we are going to study the another atomic model. That is the Bohr's atomic model. The Bohr's atomic model is going to consider different theories. First one is the Bohr's atomic model is going to consider, the Bohr's atomic model. Next, we are going to study about the Bohr's atomic model. To understand the Bohr's atomic model, we should have knowledge on Rutherford's model of atom. We should have knowledge on Planck's quantum theory. And we should have knowledge on quantization of energy of electrons. Once again, we should have knowledge on quantization of energy of electrons. Why we should have knowledge on quantization of energy of electrons? Why? Because means in the Rutherford model, all of you know the Rutherford's atomic model. In the Rutherford atomic model, what we learn is, atom is considered as spherical. And most of the mass of the atom, the total mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom. That center of the atom is called as nucleus. Nucleus is going to contain protons and neutrons. But during the time of Rutherford, there are no neutrons. Rutherford does not know about the neutrons. So Rutherford arranged protons at the center of the atom. and Rutherford arranged electrons. Rutherford arranged electrons in the circular paths around the nucleus of atom. Once again, Rutherford arranged the electrons around the nucleus in the circular paths, and the circular paths are called as orbits. This is orbits. So this is according to Rutherford's model. But whenever the electron is continuously revolving, electron is nothing but a charged particle. Once again, the electron is nothing but a charged particle. When the charged particle is continuously revolving, it should lose energy. So when the electron is continuously revolving around the nucleus, the electron should lose energy, and nucleus is going to have what? The nucleus is going to have protons. Protons are the positively charged particles. Whereas electrons are the negatively charged particles. Between the positively charged particles to negatively charged particles, there must be the attraction, electrostatic force of attraction. Because of that electrostatic force of attraction between positively charged protons to negatively charged electrons, the electrons should slowly attracted by the nucleus. Once again, the electrons should slowly attracted by the nucleus, and the electrons should jump into the nucleus. But the electrons are not jumping into the nucleus. This was not explained by Rutherford. This is a drawback. Why the electrons are not jumping into the nucleus? That was not explained. To explain that one, to explain the electrons, why they are not going to jump into the nucleus, we have to understand quantization of energy of electrons. Once again, to understand why the electrons are only revolving in the orbits, why the electrons are not jumping into the nucleus, we have to understand quantization of energy of electrons. So our topic is quantization of energy of electrons. Quantization of energy of electrons. This is our topic, we have to understand. So by understanding these concepts, then we will move for Bohr's atomic model. So to understand the Bohr's atomic model, we are learning all these things. So to understand the Bohr's atomic model, we should have knowledge on quantization of energies of electrons. Right. When the charged particles are going to move in a circular path, the charged particles are going to have some acceleration. When the accelerated charged particles are revolving around the nucleus, they are going to produce electric field as well as magnetic field. That fields are perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the path of the electron. So what are perpendicular? Electric field produced by the electron, magnetic field produced by the electron, both are perpendicular to each other, and they are perpendicular to the path of the electron. And that fields produced are called as electromagnetic radiations. Electromagnetic radiations. We are having so many types of electromagnetic radiations. All of you know about different types of electromagnetic radiations. First, I am going to show you the different types of electromagnetic radiations. Yes, all of you know about gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, infrared rays, microwaves, radio waves. Once again, all of you know about gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, microwaves, radio waves. Right. Among all of this, we can see only certain part of electromagnetic radiation. Once again, we can see only certain part of electromagnetic radiation. That certain part of electromagnetic radiation is called as visible light. Visible light. Visible light is nothing but white light. Once again, the visible light is nothing but white light. So the white light is containing different types of colors, 7 colors, WIBZR. In the last classes, I explained the WIBZR is a group of different wavelengths containing radiation that is present in the visible region. What is the visible region means? See here, visible region. On the screen, you are seeing visible spectrum. The visible region is starting from 400 nanometers to the visible spectrum or the visible region of electromagnetic spectrum is starting from 400 nanometers to 750 nanometers. On the left side, you are seeing 400 nanometers. On the right side, you are seeing 750 nanometers. Once again, these values are given in nanometers. And these values are representing wavelengths of different colors of radiations, which are present in the visible spectrum. If you see the left side is having 400 nanometers radiation, and the color is violet color, 400 nanometers. Whereas on the right side, 750 nanometers is there, red color. So in the visible spectrum, from violet color to red color, once again, in the visual spectrum, from violet color to red color, the wavelength of radiations get increases. Once again, my statement, in the visual spectrum, from violet color to red color, the wavelength of electromagnetic radiations get increases. Visual spectrum lies between, 400 nanometers to 750 nanometers. So all these are the values representing the wavelengths of different colored radiations. Okay, wavelengths. What is the relation between wavelength and frequency? Can anybody say what is the relation between wavelength and frequency? What is the relation between wavelength and frequency? Wavelength is indicated by lambda, and frequency is indicated by mu. What is the relation? Whether they are directly proportional? Yes, very good. So wavelength and frequency are inversely proportional. We can write frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength. Once again, statement, frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength. Okay, fine. Once again, see the spectrum. Once again, see the visual spectrum. Yes, on the screen, you can see the visual spectrum. On the screen, you are seeing the visual spectrum. Yes, tell me, among the visual spectrum, that is VIBZR, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Once again, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Which radiation is going to have maximum frequency? In the visible spectrum, which radiation is going to have maximum frequency? Which radiation is going to have maximum frequency? Yes, correct. Violet color radiation is going to have maximum frequency, and red color radiation is going to have minimum frequency. Yes, you can see the frequencies here. See the values given here. Violet color radiation, what is the frequency of violet color radiation? 7.5 into 10 to the power of 14 hertz. Once again, the violet color radiation frequency is 7.5 into 10 to the power of 14 hertz, whereas red color radiation is, the red color radiation is 4 into 10 to the power of 14 hertz. So by seeing these two values, violet color radiations are having more frequency. Violet color radiations are having more frequency. Red color radiations are having less frequency. Yes, coming to the point, what is the relation between energy and frequency? What is the relation between energy and frequency? What is the relation between energy and frequency? Energy is written as, energy of electromagnetic radiation is written as E, and frequency of electromagnetic radiation, the frequency of electromagnetic radiation is written as nu. What is the relation between energy and frequency of electromagnetic radiations? Yes, directly proportional. Energy and frequency of electromagnetic radiations are directly proportional. Very good. And in the VIBZR, which radiations are having maximum frequency? In the VIBZR, which radiations are having maximum frequency? In the VIBZR, which radiations are having maximum frequency? Right. Violet color radiations are having maximum frequency. Means violet color radiations are having maximum energy. Once again, my statement, violet color radiations are having maximum frequency, indicating that violet color radiations are having maximum energy. Whereas red color radiations are having, suppose if you take the red color radiations are having low frequency. The red color radiations are having low frequency means the red color radiations are having less energy. So once again, I'm showing you the spectrum, visible spectrum, just a minute. Yes, once again, you can see the visible spectrum on the screen. So in the visible spectrum, finally you can understand that according to the wavelengths, violet color radiation is having less wavelength, but according to the energy and frequency, violet color radiation is having maximum energy and maximum frequency. So anyhow, this visible spectrum is a part of electromagnetic spectrum. And you are seeing, is there any gap between one color to another color? In this visible spectrum, is there any gap between one color to another color? There is no gap. No gap means this spectrum is known as continuous spectrum. Once again, this type of spectrum is known as continuous spectrum. Yes, you will get a doubt. Sir, what is meant by spectrum? Spectrum is nothing but a group of electromagnetic radiations of different wavelengths. Once again, my statement, a group of different electromagnetic radiations of different wavelengths, collectively known as spectrum. So on the screen, you are seeing the spectrum. This spectrum is visible to the naked eye. Hence, it is called as visible spectrum. So except of this visible spectrum, remaining electromagnetic radiations, we cannot see. For example, X-rays. We cannot see the X-rays. We cannot see the UV rays. We cannot see the infrared rays. If you are using any remote, suppose if it is considered as a remote, TV remote, and there is a TV, I'm going to press the buttons on the remote. Some rays is going to be released and the rays are going to reach the TV. What are the rays? The remote is going to release the rays, infrared rays. Once again, the remote releasing the rays or the infrared rays, we cannot see. So different types of electromagnetic radiations are there. X-rays, gamma rays, UV rays, visible rays, infrared rays, radio waves, microwaves. So except of the visible rays, remaining radiations, we cannot see. Suppose here I am standing around me. So many radiations will be there, but I cannot see because my eyes are able to see only visible spectrum. Anyhow, spectrum means a group of electromagnetic radiations with a different wavelengths or a different frequencies is called as a spectrum. And spectrums are of two types, continuous spectrums and discontinuous spectrums. On the screen, you are seeing the spectrum that is a continuous spectrum. With ZR is an example of continuous spectrum. But to understand the quantization of energies of electrons, once again, to understand the topic quantization of energies of electrons, to understand about quantization of energies of electrons, we have to understand about discontinuous spectrums. By understanding the discontinuous spectrums, then only we are able to understand what is meant by quantization of energy of electrons, right? Suppose if any matter, suppose this duster is taken, what the matter is made up of? Once again, my question, what the matter is made up of? The matter is made up of atoms. Yes, correct. The matter is made up of atoms. Suppose if this matter is taken and some radiations are passed through this matter, whether this matter can absorb all radiations or not. When a matter is taken and some radiations are going to be passed on to the matter, whether this matter can absorb all types of radiations or not. No, because any matter can absorb some part of the radiation. Once again, any matter can absorb only some part of the radiations. What about the remaining radiations? If the remaining radiations are passed through a prism and passed onto a photo plate, that is a photographic plate, we will get a spectrum. That spectrum is called as absorption spectrum. Once again, onto the matter, when we are going to pass some electromagnetic radiations, this matter is going to absorb some part of the radiations and the remaining radiations are passed through a slit and they are passed through a prism and the remaining radiations are collected on a photographic plate, then we will obtain a spectrum on the photographic plate. That spectrum is called as absorption spectrum. Why it is called as absorption spectrum means because the body is going to absorb some radiations. The remaining radiations are only passed through the slit and passed through the prism and they are collected on the photographic plate. Then we are getting the spectrum. That is called as absorption spectrum. Okay? And coming to the emission spectrum. Whenever some body is going to be striked with some radiation, this body containing atoms or molecules, once again, the body containing atoms or molecules, they are going to get excited by the absorption of radiation. So when the atoms or molecules are going to get excited, they are going to the excited states. Generally, the atoms and the molecules are in the ground state. When they are going to gain the energy, the atoms and molecules are going to get excited. Excite means moving from lower energy level to higher energy level. That process is called as excitation. So when the excitation is happening, when the body is going to strike with some radiations, the body containing atoms or molecules are going to absorb some radiations. Because of that absorbed radiations, the atoms or the molecules in the body are going to get excited. Now the atoms or molecules are in the excited state. But the atoms or the molecules in the excited state, they are unstable. Immediately they are going to lose energy. So how they are going to lose energy? How they are going to lose energy? That body which is containing the excited atoms or the body which is containing the excited molecules, they are going to emit radiations. When the emitted radiations are going to be recorded on a photographic film, once again, when the excited atoms going to emit radiations, if the emitted radiations are recorded on a photographic film, then the obtained spectrum is called as emission spectrum. So spectrums are of two types. One is absorption spectrum. Second one is emission spectrum. Here I'm going to show you the absorption spectrum and emission spectrum. Just a minute. I will show you the diagrams. So all these are the basics. By understanding these basics only, we can go to the topic clearly. Yes, on the screen you can see two types of spectrums. Emission spectrum and absorption spectrum. In the first one, sorry, in the second one, B. See the B. A source of white light is taken. See the B only. A source of white light is taken. That white light is passed through a absorbing sample. Nothing but a substance. Nothing but a substance. So this circle is indicating a substance. So when a white light is passed through a substance, that substance is going to absorb some part of the radiation. This substance is going to absorb some part of the radiation. Remaining radiations are passed through a slit and they are passed through a prism. And through the prism, when the light is going to be passed, that light is going to get dispersed. Dispersion of light is going to happen. So the dispersion light is collected on the photographic film or a film detector. Then we will see the spectrum. This spectrum is called as absorption spectrum. Whereas if you see the first one, A, small a. Now this is the substance. Which type of substance it is means? This substance is going to contain excited atoms, excited sample, excited atoms. Through this substance, when the substance is going to release radiations, that emitted radiations are passed through the slit and passed through the prism and they are going to get dispersed and the dispersed radiations are collected on a photographic film, then we will get the spectrum that is called as emission spectrum. Just a minute, I have to take the attendance. Tomorrow also I will explain the same concept if you are not understood. Already I sent the PDF, my dear students, please read the PDF. You can easily understand today's topic. So by understanding today's topic only, we can understand next class, that is quantization of energies of electrons. So from that quantization of energies of electrons, then we will move for hydrogen spectrum. Just a minute once again. Had to take the attendance properly. Yes, text me whether the class is understood or not. Text me in the chat box whether the class is understood or not.